In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a really simple heads-up display in Spark AR Studio. First, we need to make our HUD elements. I've made these in After Effects, using the ellipse tool, adding a dash, and then rotating it slowly. This comp is only 600 by 600 pixels and 12 frames per second. That's because we only have a 4 megabyte limit to what Instagram can handle as a filter. And it also has a transparent background. I've also made two or more HUD elements, which are variations on that rotating circle. We need to export these as an image sequence. So to do that, we go to Composition, Add to Render Queue, and under the Output module, make sure we choose PNG Sequence, and make sure the channel is RGB plus alpha, to make sure that it'll render with a transparent background. Let's do that for all the elements, and let's render those to individual folders. Now let's open Spark AR Studio. Spark AR Studio is free on Windows and Mac OS, and I'm going to switch the camera view to my webcam. And the first thing we're going to do is add a new asset. Down here on the left in the Assets panel, we're going to click Add Asset and select Animation Sequence. And let's rename that HUD Circle 1. And then over here on the right where it says Texture, we're going to select Choose File, find where our After Effects renders were saved to, and select all of them in Circle 01, and click Open. That's now added down here as a texture in our assets panel. And let's make sure to change the frame rate to 12 frames per second, which was what we animated it in. And now let's repeat that process, adding the other two elements from our HUD. Now those three animation sequences have been added, let's go track them to our face. Over here in our scene panel, we're going to select Add Object, select Face Tracker and click Insert. And I can probably make out faintly these little arrows that are tracking my face down in the center. And now let's add a new object, and this time we're going to add a plane and select Insert. Now to get this plane to track to my face, we need to go over here in the scene panel and just drag it onto our face tracker. Now this plane follows wherever I look. To get our animation onto this plane, we go over here on the right, and where it says materials, we're going to click the plus to create a new material, which is called material 0. Let's rename that down here in the panel as well. And then with this material selected, go over to texture, drop down, and then select HUD circle 1. And now we can see it's tracked into our scene and it's stuck to my face. It is way too small at the moment, so let's go over and select our plane over here and we can adjust the scale. So on the X and Y axes, let's change this to 2.5. And because this plane doesn't have depth, we don't need to worry about changing the Z axis scale. So to get the other HUD elements in this scene, I'm going to go down to our materials, select HUD circle 1 and duplicate that with Command or Control D. And I'm going to do that twice. And for HUD Circle 2, we're going to change the texture to HUD Circle 2. And for HUD Circle 3, HUD Circle 3. And now we can go over to our plane here and duplicate that with Control D. And on plane 1, change its materials to HUD Circle 2. And that's been added straight on top of our first HUD element. To get a bit of separation between these two, we can go down to the middle here, select this blue arrow, and just drag it out a little bit. Now you can see if I move my head, we've got a nice bit of parallax that you can see, where it's been pushed forward in Z-axis and it's closer to the camera. Let's duplicate this plane again and change that material to HUD Circle 3. And let's push this one even closer still. You can add as many of these elements as you want and adjust them to fill up your HUD to your desire. There, that's looking full enough for me now. Once we're done, to get this onto Instagram, what we need to do is go to File, Export, and follow the prompts that will send you to Spark AR Hub, which will allow you to publish on Instagram. There is a review time and it is getting longer, so at the moment I wouldn't expect it to be approved for at least 10 days, but that could change in the future. Please let me know if you want more AR tutorials on this channel. This is just scratching the surface.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.